Hi everyone, I'm Sofan. Welcome to CMI's Digital Classes. Today we'll learn about Chapter 4, Division. Okay, we all are familiar with the division from your earlier classes, but here we will learn first some properties of division. Okay, some properties why you used to learn, because from the property, using property if you do, your division will be slightly easier. थोड़ा सा easy हो जाता है property से करने से, क्योंकि कुछ कुछ properties होता है जिससे हम लोग division को उतना नहीं करना पड़ता है. हम लोग जानते हैं कि ऐसा होता है. For example, here it is asking properties number one, that if the dividend is zero, dividend is zero and the divisor is a non-zero number. Okay, so whenever you are dividing zero with any particular number, then the answer is always zero. कोई भी जीरो को कितनों से भी आप भागा कर दें, कितना भी डिवाइड करें, वो जीरो ही होगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जीरो डिवाइडेड बाई सेवन इज जीरो, जीरो डिवाइडेड बाई फोर इज ऑलरेडी रिटन, सो इलेवन इज जीरो, जीरो डिवाइडेड बाई ट्वेंटी इज जीरो. सो वट एवर यू आर डिवाइडिंग फ्रॉम जीरो विथ जीरो, द आंसर विल बी ऑलवेज zero. So when dividend is zero and the divisor is any particular number, the quotient will always be zero. हमेशा उसका जो quotient होगा वो zero ही होगा. Okay, so ये matter नहीं करता है कि कोई भी number यहाँ पे, ये जो divisor है, divisor कोई भी number हो, आपका जो quotient होगा वो zero ही होगा. This is the first property of division. Property number two is saying कि when the divisor is one, when the divisor is one, when you are dividing one, okay, and the dividend is any number, the quotient is same number as the dividend. Okay, so that means it does. For example, you need to place this in a particular. How we used to do is, these are the things. So suppose you are dividing this. Okay. So here divisor is one. How many times is 26? Definitely 26 times is 26. Okay. So how much is the quotient? 26. So this is the quotient. This is the divisor. Okay. This is the divisor. So this is the most important thing is to understand. Which is the divisor and which is the dividend. Okay, so this is the dividend and this is the divisor. Don't be confused with this. These two terms normally people used to confuse with. Quotient is very simple. Okay, so in this case, whenever you are dividing any particular number by one, always the answer will be that particular number itself. For example, 238 divided by 1 will always be 238 only. Suppose 89 divided by 1 will be 89 only. Okay, 64 divided by 1 will be 64 itself. So this number itself will be the answer whenever you are dividing by 1 into a particular number. This is the second property. If the divisor is 1 and dividend is any particular number, then the quotient will be the same number itself. Okay. Next property says, if the dividend and the divisor are the same number. For example, dividend is also 7 and divisor is also 7. Then what happens? Always the quotient will be 1. Okay. So, जब भी divisor और dividend सेम होता है, सेम नंबर होता है, तो आंसर हमेशा क्या होगा? 1 होगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 586 डिवाइडेड बाय 586, सो हाउ मच विल बी द आंसर? 1. 428 डिवाइडेड बाय 428 विल बी 1. ओके, 19 डिवाइडेड बाय 19 will be 1. Always, if we are dividing same number by same number, then the answer will definitely come same. So this is how, if we dividing same number with the same number, then means dividend and divisor are same, then the percent will be 1. You don't need to check by dividing, that will be definitely 1 in all the cases. Now let's discuss about the division by 10s, 100s and 1000s. Okay, so division by 10s, 1000s and 100s is also easy. Just one logic you have to understand here. Suppose you are dividing particular number by 1, definitely it will be the same number, but remainder will be 0. There will not be any remainder, as from the property of the divisor you know, if you are dividing any particular number by 1, the answer will come the same number itself. Okay, so the same number itself and nothing percent, cosine will be 0. Now suppose the same number we are dividing by 10. Agar same number ko hum log 10 se divide karte hain, to kya hoga ki 10s ones place ka jo number hota hai, ones place ka jo number hota hai wo carry ban jayega, baki 10s place tak jo hai aapka same number rahega. Kyunki 1 se divide kar rahe ho to 4320 is here, is equal to 4320, and then 4 will be left, so 4 will be remainder. So here 432 into 10 is equal to 4320. मतलब अगर इसमें और एक जीरो ऐड कर देंगे तो इतना होगा और 4 बच जाएगा, तो 4 जो है वो रिमाइंडर में चल जाएगा. ठीक है, सो सेम वे इन केस ऑफ 100 व्हाट हैपेंस, इन केस ऑफ 10 वन डिजिट जो था, वन डिजिट लास्ट का वो कैरी बच गया. इन केस ऑफ 100 लास्ट का 2 डिजिट कैरी बच जाएगा और ये जो होगा ये हम लोग का कोसाइन होगा और ये रिमाइंडर होगा. सेम वे फॉर 3 डिजिट, लास्ट का जो 3 डिजिट है ये बच जाएगा हम लोग का और ये जो है ये कोसाइन हो जाएगा. ठीक है, बिकॉज 1 4 आर 4000, सो 4000 यहाँ पे हो जाएगा और ये रिमाइंडर हो जाएगा. ठीक है, तो इसी तरह से अगर कोई भी पर्टिकुलर नंबर को हम लोग या तो 10, 100 और 1000 से डिवाइड करते हैं, यू नो नीड टू चेक बाय डिवाइडिंग. यू कैन डायरेक्टली डू लाइक दिस. इफ इट इज आस्किंग फॉर 100, वी विल कीप 2 डिजिट, 0 इज देयर इन 100, सो 2 डिजिट विल कीप एज रिमाइंडर. ओके, एंड देन रेस्ट 2 डिजिट विल बी फॉर विल बी द कोसाइन. ओके, सेम केस इफ इट इज सपोज 4 डिजिट, सपोज आई एम टेकिंग एन एग्जांपल ऑफ 5 डिजिट. ओके, 6 3 8 2 9, and I am asking to divide this by 10,000. Okay, so here 4 zero are here, so we will write 4 digit. Okay, as remainder. So this will be the only cosine. So 6 will be the cosine. Okay, and 3 8 2 9 will be the remainder. So this is how you can divide any particular number by 100, 10 or thousands or 10,000s. Okay. Now next topic which we have is division by one digit number. Okay. So if it is given for one digit number, how can we divide? These are already you have done loss, but let's see, let's revise once. How can we divide? Maybe few of the students don't know also. Okay. So this by this we have to divide. Okay. So 2 8 5 9 divided by 6. Okay, so first thing which we need to take care in division is this number, largest place value number, like largest place value digit of the number. So here this is 6 and this is 2. So 6 we cannot 2 we cannot divide by 6. So in that case we used to take 2 digit. Okay, so if you take 2 digit, then it will become 28. Now we will read the table of 6. 6 का टेबल हम लोग पढ़ेंगे और चेक करेंगे 6 का टेबल में कितना में या तो 20 से कम या तो 28 से कम या तो 28 आ जाए. ओके, बट इट शुड नॉट बी मोर देन 28 से ज्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए. तो जस्ट यू हैव टू रीड द टेबल ऑफ 5, सॉरी टेबल ऑफ 6. ओके, सो वी नो 4 6 आर 24. ओके, सो व्हिच इज लेस देन 28, but if we go to the 5 6 5, so 6 5 are 30, which is more than this. Okay, so we will take 6 4. Okay, so 6 4 are 24. So now we have to do subtraction list. Okay, so 4 plus 4 is 8, Okay, here 2 plus 2 and 2 is subtracted is 0. So 4 is the remainder here. You no need to write 0 here. Okay, so 4 we got. Now, again, this we have to divide by this, but here this is less, so we have to take 1 from here. So 5 will come here and it will become 45. Okay, now we have to again check the table of 6 and check that this is at how much, with how much time 6 is equal to either 45 or less than 45. कितना टेबल का अगर हम लोग पढ़ेंगे, 6 का टेबल अगर हम लोग पढ़ेंगे तो कितना बार में या तो 45 होता है या तो 45 से कम होता है, ये हम लोग को देखना है. सो लेट्स सी हाउ मेनी टाइम्स 6 6 आर 36, 6 7 आर 42, 6 8 आर 48, 48 इज मोर देन 45. ओके, सो 6 7 आर 42, सो 6 7 आर 42. Now again we have to subtract this. So how much? 3, 4, 4, 0, we don't need to write. Again this 9 will come here. Okay. 1, 1 digit will come here. So 9, it will be 39. So again we have to read the table of 6 and check which is the number at how, with how much it should be either 39 or less than that. So let's read the table of 6. 6, 7 are 42, which is more than this. Okay, so 6, 6 are 36. So 6, 6 are 36. So 3 is the remainder. This one also you use to subtract, you don't need to give subtraction sign here. Okay, but you can give because we are doing subtractions for the, your understanding only. Okay, so 3 is the remainder here. 476 is the quotient here. Okay. And here you have to just write all the terms so that you can understand also. Therefore, answer will be cosec is equal to 476. Okay, and remainder is equal to 3. This is the answer. This is how you can solve the division of any particular number by one digit. Okay. Next topic which we have is division by two digit number. So I hope you can do the rest of all division of one digit number by yourself. So let's move to the next topic. Division by two digit number is only here the number will be of two digit. The rest of all process will be same. So here we have to divide by 12, 7, 3, 5, 4. So let's divide. For this you have to know the table of 12. Okay, so 12, how many times is equal to 12? Also you have to check this 12, one digit cannot be possible, two digit will check. Okay, so 12, how many times is equal to 73? That you have to check first. Okay, so let's read the table of 12. 12 1 are 12, 12 2 are 24, 12 3 are 36. 12, 4 are 5, 6, 6 less 6, 6 times because 7 this is. So 12, 6 are 72. 12, 6 are 72. Okay, so 6 times. 12, 6 times is 72. Okay, so 1 is carry 5. 12, 1 definitely. 2 will be more than that. So 1, 12, 1 are 12. 13, 14, 15. So 3, 4, 34. So how many times 12 is equal to 34? 12. 2 are 20, 12, 4, 24, 12, 2 are 24, 12, 3 are 36, 36 is more than that, so 2, 12, 2 are 24, so 10. So here the quotient is equal to 612 and remainder is equal to 10. Okay. So this is how you can do the division by two digits. Okay. So here quotient will be 612. Remainder will be 10. Okay. So that's all about this question. So now we will check together how to verify the answer, how to check the answer is correct or not also with this example. So this question is asking solve this and check the answer. So you have to solve first and check that the particular answer is correct or not. Okay. So first let's divide this. Okay. So let's divide this. By 28 we are dividing 6, 7, 8, 9, 2. Okay. So this two digit first we will check. So 2 times it will be 4, 3 times it will be 6, 3, 8. No, no. It will be 3 times 4. So let's see 2 times. 228 are 228 are it will be 56. Let's see. 56. Okay. So now here 1. Eight to our 6 and 6, 1 carry. 2 or 4, 5, 56. 1. Okay. So now this 8 will come down. And this is also 1. Okay. So 8 will come down. So 118. So 118, how many times? 5 to our 10, 6 to our 12. So it will be more. 5 to our 10 also will be more. So as because 8 is also here, so 4 times that 4 8 are 32. So 32 is 2, 3 carry, 4 2 are 8, 9 2, 9 9 11. So 11, 112, right? So 112, so 6 0 0. Okay, so this come down. Now 9 will come down. Okay, so 9, 69 again, 67 is here, so 2 times only. So 2, 28 and 56, because 3 times it will be more. 60, 70 it will be, okay, 3 times. So 2 times, now 6, 7, 8, 9, 3, okay, 13. Now 2 will come down, so 2, 132, so 132, 4 time is 112, 5 time it will be 140, so it will be more, so definitely it will be with 4 times and 112, so 0, 2, 20 is the remainder and percent is 2424. So now we will verify this, is this correct or not. So what is the formula to verify is, just we multiply this with this, means cosine into divisor plus remainder. Sorry, cosine into divisor. Cosine into divisor is equal to dividend. So it's so simple to verify. Just you have to multiply cosine with the divisor and you have to add the remainder. You will find the dividend. If the dividend comes, this number comes, then you can ensure that this division is correct. So here cosine is equal to 2424 multiply divisor is equal to 28 and remainder is equal to 20. Okay, so now let's solve this. If this comes, then this is correct. So first multiply these two and add 20, definitely this number will come. Okay, then answer will be verified. How much it will come? 70, 92 minus 20 is 72. Okay, so 6, 7, 8, 7, 2 plus 20. So it will be 6, 7, 8, 9, 2. Okay, so this is how you can verify that the division is correct or not. This type of question is very important for your exam, that solve this, divide this, and after then you have to check also. then maximum of the students used to do up to the division only, but this is the most important steps. You have to verify also that, you have to show also by verifying that this answer is correct. This is how we can say that this is correct. Okay, that's all about up to exercise 4.3. next we will learn about the word problems of multiplications. Okay, so sorry, word problems of divisions. So here now you can do in homework exercise 4.1 to 4.3 by yourself. So this is your homework. Okay, that's all. Thank you, have a good time, take care.